Well, when I first met the band, they were just a four-piece band, long-haired and scruffy, in about 73 or 74, about then. And in Adelaide in those days, what you had to do to get work was to be a top 40 band and do cover versions of top 40 songs, and you got a lot of work that way. So they were instantly the rebels, of course, because they didn't do any top 40 songs. They just did their covers of Led Zeppelin. In those days, they didn't do any originals. Nobody would give them any work at all because of the fact that they were either too loud, they didn't crawl to the promoters, they drank, they got drunk. So, as I said, I was running some venues as well. They approached me to get them work, and after a while, that meeting ended up into management. I was managing them and booking them through my agency.
The only place that one could play in those days, which was, we're talking about 1976, 77, was this grotty little wine bar, French's, in Oxford Street, which is still there, of course, and most people would know it or have dragged themselves in or out of it at one time or another. So we thought we'd go up and see the guy that ran French's, and we walked in that night, and there was a band playing, and they'd just blown up the PA, and it was Chisel. and they'd blown up the PA, but it didn't stop Barnes singing, and when he'd had enough of that, he went up to the bar to have a drink, and they started to play Georgia. It was the first time that I'd ever heard it. And, you know, there was another guy singing who was a great singer as well. And I thought, boy, you know, like, they're really doing it the hard way.
Once I smoked a damn immense cigar, I drove a foreign car. Remember, that was years ago. She died. The only needle, she was crucified. There, but that was years ago. I left her behind. Her phone now, a cheap wine and a three-day grow. Cheap wine and a three-day grow. Come on, oh come on, oh come on. From those that I despise, from there back I don't need your love. I don't need your love. Whenever you can shout at me, but you can't meet my eyes, and I don't really need your love. I don't. A cheap wine and a three-day grow. Come on, oh come on, oh come on, come on. I'm sitting on the beach drinking rock and fuels, oh yeah. I spent the all night breaking all the rules, oh yeah, yeah. I'm manning every minute of a day.
Jim didn't turn up till about, say, May of 73. He would have been about 16 or something at the time. And so he came along to a practice one time, and he was a real sort of a roughie. You know, I remember meeting him, he didn't shake hands with everybody, he sort of like stood back and sort of more prepared to sort of to block a punch rather than shake hands, you know.
I had a little mini minor, and Steve and Jim always used to fight. And I mean, fight, really punch fight. And I can remember one night we were going to a party. Jim was in the front, Steve was in the back, and they just fought like crazy. I was going down the main street of Adelaide. I'm getting fists across my head and my shoulder being pushed, and I'm trying to keep it on the straight road. Anyway, in the end, the car careered into the medium strip, and we were totally oblivious to the fact, of course, while this was going on, that there was a police car following us. And I got picked up and booked, and while that was all happening, these two are still fighting in the mini minor.
If anybody wants to jive in the audience, Catch a fleet and steal a bag again. The Robinson son just stole my girl away. And now we're apart, thinking about her every day. With the scuffle of a little feet around her head. Getting no cause of getting no mail. The girl ain't on the town anymore. If she don't come home, I know it's where I'm gonna go. I said the Robinson son just stole my girl away. The Robinson son just stole my girl away. Rise, son, just stole my girl. I'm gonna catch a fiend and steal her bag again. Rise, son, just stole my girl away. Well, that might not be just send the transit, let it fall to me. If I think that they can't take her away, I'm stealing her bag again. Yeah, shake it one time now, come on. Thank you.
when we did the first album, we sort of had these ideas that we weren't really a singles band, you know, and we were going to try and get away with it if we could without doing any singles. We thought we'd just try and be an album band. But when we released the first album, all the radio stations sort of were sort of ringing up the office and sort of saying, everybody jumped, bumped into, sort of said, K-San should be your first single. So we thought, all right, you know, we didn't have a clue what we were doing, really, so we thought we'd put out a single, K-San. And it got banned about 2 weeks later.
I left my heart to the devil's realm, K-San. And I sold my soul with my cigarettes to the black market man. Had the Vietnam cold turkey from the ocean to the silver city. And it's only other vets could understand about the love of God and dark side guarantee. There were no B-Day heroes in 1973. And how we sailed in a Sydney harbor, I saw an old man by the good and killed her. But she was lying and I was home to Lucky Land. She was like so many more from that time on. The lives are all so empty until they found their chosen one. The legs were either knowing, but their minds were always closed. And their hearts were held in fast suburban shame. And the legal pads were yellow, I was all payback seen. And until I cried, I screamed out where the gunshots was a bit. A drop box made me jump, and I never stop a dream. What a growing need for speed and overkill. So I worked across the country from anywhere, tried to find a place to settle down where my mixed up life from here. I held a job on a lorry, I fired shovels with our crew, but the nightlife nearly drove me round the field. And I travel around the world from year to year, and each one found me aimless, but one more year the worse for wear. And I've been back south these days, you know the answer sure ain't there. And I'm drifting off to check things out again. You feel me?
I'm gone.
when we were doing the Bird Noises EP up at the Music Farm in northern New South Wales, we'd booked in a day early just to start writing some songs and working out what we were going to do. Chisel had been somewhere up the coast and had a night off. This was a night off after, you know, 29 nights in a row, starting from Townsville and coming all the way down North Queensland, thousands of miles. But they had a night off and they said, oh, we might come down and, you know, just sit around and talk and relax and what have you and be social, which we thought was a fine idea. Of course, they came down with guitars and amplifiers and we got the piano out and, you know, the whole thing started and went till about 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning with Rob Hurst from The Oils, who's got a very loud voice, and Jimmy Barnes sort of trading Creedence Clearwater songs. And I went to bed at about 4, you know, desperate sort of thinking about the EP that we were doing the next day. And I was, you know, let's have another beer, you know, let's do another song. Oh, do you remember this one? Or do you remember that one? I mean, they were a real band in that sense, which was one of their great qualities, you know. They were real musicians and they loved their music and they played very, very, very emotionally and very strongly.
Some guys sell it live for cheap. You've heard it all before. Let's take some pet minority to fame in 84. Lots of fortune and reputations to refill. 20th century. Yankees will get east and west before they cross the other bound. Well, it's a Hollywood democracy.
With the Rock Awards in 81, that was mainly because everybody took it so seriously and they were giving us a bit of a hard time too, you know, because we wanted to play live for a start and they didn't like that because they'd lose a bit of control, you know. So we decided about half a week before the show that we were going to do something drastic and we sort of sat down and what should we do? Turned out great. We were just really killing ourselves laughing. We came off stage and I was sort of straight out the back. And then... we'd been in America for about a week, I think, and we had to go to the record company and it was the first day where we were going to meet all the execs and, you know, all the promotions people. And we walked into the offices and it was really funny because through this big corridor of offices, there's all these secretaries outside and guys inside sort of sticking their head out, hey, my baby, beautiful, you know, and all this sort of stuff. And we went into this one guy's office, and he was the guy I wrote the song about. He was head of promotions or something like that, you know. And he came in and he was supposed to be coming to see our first gig and he couldn't do it because he had to go to a DJ's dog's birthday party or something, you know. It was very important, you know.
The band had been doing prison gigs in Adelaide well before they came to Sydney. In fact, I think they did some gigs down in Melbourne while they were living there. The band's done a number of shows in Parramatta Jail. Most of the prisons around Australia, except for Bogger Road up in Brisbane, we tried to get in up there.
All jail situations are extremely disciplined. I think the concerts we did were somewhat less disciplined than what they're used to in there, but certainly nothing like an outside gig. You know? I mean, everybody has to stay in their seats and you know, the walls are lined by prison officers and they're allowed to applaud by clapping.
better than they say. I said a roll, a river of light, a million souls. I'm 3 days out from Parramatta jail. Well, organized all was out of control. And those rubber men, they're all using my name. Well, they hold the power, but I hold the blame. But I don't know love burns deep enough to hide you. A military mind, crawling in your wish. Well, I don't want to know about tomorrow. 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 Oh, no. Oh, no. Well, all that sweet, come on. Clutching the straw. In the future, I'm busting the doors. But get in here! Enough on the road. For all 20 more years, for all the God, and I don't know love burns deep enough to hide you. But military man, what do you wish for?
I don't wanna know about
you. I don't wanna know about the
moon.
Shadows, you know, well, they got us in their sights. I don't want to know about tomorrow, man. She said, I'm free tonight. Wow.
Star Hotel. The event itself was a riot at a small local hotel in Newcastle. It very quickly attained a certain mythology because of the times that were going on at that stage. The country seemed to be dividing in two. There was no government for that half of the nation.
A spend that night under custody.
She's crying like a refugee. Yes, she is.
Circus Animals. At the time that we were preparing for that album, we developed an extensive live touring circuit around Australia. We were travelling through country towns, also playing in the cities. And also we did our first trip to America and had the same kind of existence there, a lot of travelling, which from the inside of an organisation is a very nomadic existence. From the outside of an organisation, the whole show is very transitory. You know, it comes into town and the whole thing is very much like the late 20th century equivalent of the small travelling circus or sideshow.
Listen out to the wind, babe. And listen out to the rain. You know I feel like water licking at my feet. And I don't want to see this town no more. Wasting my days on a factory floor. The first thing you'll know, I'll be back in my river. The first thing you know, I will be back in my river. The first thing you know, I'll be back in my river again. Separates me from the red top. I've been working hard 12 hours a day. The money I save and buy my guilty gift. I'm going for the heat, babe, and a tropical rain. In a place where no man putting on the door for me. Waiting on a week up, try to brand new time.
These days, I like to stay on my farm out of Sydney a lot, mainly because when I'm working, it's so hectic, I don't need that when I'm off. I just need the rest, and, you know, we don't get any rest when we're in the city, so we stay on the farm, and I ride my horses and take my daughter Mahalia out in the country. Bullshit anyway. You know it takes more than just a memory to make me cry. And I'm happy just to sit here round the table with old friends and see which one of them can tell the biggest lie. And there's a girl, she's falling in love.
We had already sold quite a few records in Germany previous with a label called Lion Records, who had sort of picked up the imports and brought them into Germany. So we'd sold a few there and we had a bit of a following. The club scene wasn't too bad. We could handle that. It was fairly difficult doing supports and playing for 45 minutes or an hour before a band when an audience isn't really interested in you, which is sort of what most people have to do when they support us, I suppose, over here. But we'd been through that once, and it sort of was fairly difficult to actually get into that again and sort of try and pull yourself above it.
Thank you.
We're still learning, okay?
The most enjoyable sort of ultimate feeling that I think all of us have felt would probably be, would have to be the last shows we did at the Entertainment Centre. It was quite rewarding, but at the same time quite sad to think that this was the last one. And that the sort of feeling we got from those last shows was, I think, what we'd all been striving for the whole 10 years the band had been together.
Well, obviously you sort of build up a bit of something more than sort of camaraderie. It's because we've basically been living together for a long time, you know, touring, you know, Australia, you know, New Zealand, America, Europe, blah, blah, blah. Literally sort of living together, travelling together. You know the old saying, you know, your friends are the people who, you know all their faults as well, but you still like them. You know, that's, I think that's what it boils down to.
Let's go sing a few songs.
Where's the
shirt? Have you ever been arrested before?
You're in.
Give her 5 years.
This is the curtain on the edge of stage.
He was off with the badge and everything. Terrible.
Can't bring that anywhere.
I didn't mean to yell at
you. No, 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 no. I survived there. You make my heart sing.
Now, baby. Oh, you make me go wild now, baby. Oh, yeah, 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 oh, yeah.
Roll!
to be over this. I'm a coming down the stairs. Well, and I ain't gonna listen to no more fizz on the rim. Oh, has every long years to give a little thing, a little thing, a little money away. Well, anybody believe it, I'm gonna take it to the love of town. Turn all the tears and shed, and don't forget to let the neighbors see. Oh, what a low down there you got when you marry me. Drown your day in the valley, everybody. I'm talking to the guy in the door. But you can show off your cheap branch for society.
First time. Without breaking down into tears. I'd like to thank you all for coming. Now, that's it. Fuck you guys, we've had a good time with you, you know? Over all these years we've fucked you about, you know? It's been great. Well, come back! I hear the whistle blows at 10 o'clock, but don't let go. Don't let go, 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 don't let go.
I hear the whistle blow, but it's 10 o'clock.
Don't let go, don't let go.
Come on now, baby, send us down the ride.
Don't let go, don't let go.
You ain't keeping no listen tight.
Don't let go, don't let go.
You ain't keeping no listen tight.
Don't let go, don't let go. Ooh, this feeling is killing me. Oh, shucks. When you stop for me in the bus, I love you so. I said, hold me tight, but don't let go. Hold me a moment, but don't let go. Stay me down, but don't let go.
Well, thunder, lightning, wind, and rain.
But don't let go, but don't let go.
I love this woman inside my brain.
But don't let go, but don't let go.
Well, I'm so happy I got you here.
But don't let go, but don't let go.
A kiss of me, a grin from my ear to ear.
But don't let go, but don't let go.
This feeling is killing me.
Oh, shucks.
I won't stop.
go get stoned. Let's go get stoned. Let's go get stoned. Let's go get stoned. But you know my baby, she won't let me in. I've got a few pennies, gonna buy me a bottle of gin, and then I'll call up my buddy on the telephone and say, come on, let's go get stoned. You know I work so hard all day long, but everything I try to do, well, it always seems to turn out wrong. And that's why I stop by here on my way home and say, let's go get stoned. 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 Don't you go falling down. Don't you know you're gonna fuss your lip. And there ain't no harm, we take a little taste. Yeah, but don't you go falling down. You're gonna mess up, you're gonna mess up some other man's way. Yes, let's go. Let's go get stoned. Let's go get stoned. Let's go get stoned.